Assalamu alaikum. Welcome back. Today we are going to study subject science, in which we are going to start a new chapter, animal life. So let's start. So let's see what are habitats. A natural home or place where an animal lives is called its habitat. The natural home or place where an animal lives is called its habitat. Let's see some examples. A bird makes a nest in a tree. So, that nest is the habitat for that bird. A penguin lives in cold or ice-covered regions. Similarly, a camel lives in the desert. So, these are the habitats for these animals. As we all know, all the living things need to breathe in oxygen for the survival. So the question arises, how do animals breathe? So let's discuss this topic. All living things breathe. Animals breathe in oxygen from the air and give out carbon dioxide. Different animals have different ways of breathing. They have different organs for breathing. Like fishes breathe through gills as water passes through the gills. The fish takes in the oxygen dissolved in the water and gives out carbon dioxide. Do you know a whale looks like a fish and lives in water, but it is not a fish. It is a mammal. A whale does not have gills. It has lungs to breathe, like human beings. Human beings also have lungs for breathing. It must come up to the surface of the water and fill its lungs with air. A whale has very large lungs so that it can take in enough oxygen in one breath to last for some time underwater. Then it comes up to the surface of the water and gives out carbon dioxide. You can see these pictures of whales and fish also. Now let's see how do other animals breathe. We will see one by one. A frog breathes through its lungs when on land and through its moist skin when in water. A baby frog, also called as tadpole, breathes through its gills. Insects such as cockroaches, caterpillars, and grasshoppers breathe through tiny air holes on their bodies called spiracles. Some animals such as earthworms take in oxygen through their moist skin. Amoeba and paramecium are tiny animals which can be seen only through a microscope. They breathe through their body surface.
Let's watch a short video on topic how do different animals breathe differently. So let's see.
Children, in the previous lesson, we saw how humans breathe and how the lung functions. But how do other living things breathe? Do they all breathe the same way? Or do they follow some other mechanism? Let us find it out. Many other land animals have lungs like humans. For example, all the mammals, that is, all the animals which give birth to young ones, say cow, goat, lion, tiger, etc. You know, even the reptiles, amphibians, birds, etc. have lungs in their chest cavities just like us. We know amphibians like frog can live both on land and in water. On land, a frog breathes through nostrils and has a pair of lungs. You must have seen frogs in the ponds too. How does it breathe in water? Well, it uses oxygen which is dissolved in water. In water, the frog takes in oxygen which is dissolved in water using its moist skin and gives out carbon dioxide. But have you ever wondered how do insects breathe? Do they have tiny lungs? No. Cockroaches and many other insects breathe through small openings or pores on their body surface. These are called spiracles. Spiracles are internally connected to many air tubes which send air to the cell. How does this happen? The oxygen-rich air rushes through the spiracles into the air tubes. The air then diffuses into the body tissue and reaches every cell of the body. Same way, carbon dioxide from the cells goes into the air tubes and finally moves out through the spiracles. The microbes don't have any organ or blood, so they just absorb oxygen directly through their body surface into the cell. The earthworm absorbs air through the body surface, but little differently. The earthworm has blood, so the air enters the blood vessels, which are just under the skin. Then the blood carries oxygen to all the cells. It is just like how frogs breathe in the water. Now, how do water animals breathe? Do all water animals breathe through skin like frog? No. A fish breathes through gills. Gills are full of blood vessels. The fish takes in water through the mouth and that water washes the gills. That time, the blood in the blood vessels absorbs the dissolved oxygen from the water. And what about plants?
Here your assignment number 3. Hope you all will complete it and send me back on WhatsApp.